Hey Internet, Gordon Ung with PC World here, joined by Steve of Gamers Nexus. I want to talk about a topic that really sets me off, and that is small form factor builds, SFF, computers which, look, everybody...
he's qualifying it.
I'm qualified. Everybody's entitled to build into the computer they want. You can buy the color you want, you can buy the parts you want, and then you're also entitled to your opinion on the things you don't like. For me, for my needs...
I'm waiting for it.
Small form factors suck. I just think small form factor computers just suck. I've said they're the coupe of the PC. Nobody wants to ride in back. They suck. And I mean, nobody. If you're a coupe owner, you know what I'm talking about. No one asks people to ride in the back seat of your car.
You can only piss off one group of people per video.
Coupe and small form factor.
You can't start it this way.
I'm just saying I don't. To me, like the main thing I don't like is because it's a pain in the ass because I run machines for a long time. I got to work on it. Something goes wrong. You got to get inside of that, son of a... And you don't want to... It's just a pain in the butt. It's not... The juice is not worth it for me. Just... I'm going to build a tower. I don't need a small machine physically. Some people do. That's cool. That's your jam.
But you still think it sucks.
I think it sucks.
If they build one.
For me. But here's why I have Steve here.
That's not what you said. You said you think they suck.
Okay, they do suck. They do...
Okay. Commit.
They demonstrably suck.
Okay, there you go.
Now, the reason is...
There's your video title. Small form factor demonstrably sucks.
Well, check this out, though. Performance. Now, Adam disagrees with me. I think small form factors are always going to be at a simple disadvantage against a full-size desktop because the full-size desktop can take a bigger power supply. It can take bigger everything, bigger... It's just better. Bigger, better.
What kind of car do you drive?
I have a Subaru... I have 18 Lamborghinis and a Subaru station wagon.
Okay. All right. Got it.
That's just the other guy.
If we were going to go like...
Other guy's reference.
See if we're going to go for the pickup truck.
Oh, I wish.
Because I'm starting to see some... You don't like coupes, and you don't like small form factor
computers. We are in a
starting to see a trend.
We're in a city that if I had a full-size pickup would be perfect, and if I lived in the city, I would have a full-size pickup. But I don't live in that city.
You would need one because you only build super tower computers.
Yes,
so super tower computers. If you ever want to bring it anywhere, then you need a pickup truck.
Yes, transporting it, small form factor is better. You got me on the transporting thing.
But what if you fly a lot and you want to bring your computer with you?
Laptop. Nobody wants to I'm going to bring my small form factor. I'm going to pack up a monitor and keyboard. If you're gone that point, you're just going to use a gaming laptop.
Okay.
Right? You can get a lot of performance in a laptop. Right. It's more expensive, but it's way less pain in the ass than trying to. And they're like, are you going to, let me ask you, Steve.
Okay.
You want to fly somewhere with your small form factor build? Like, oh my God, you just got my, I got this special edition 3090 Ti. I built it up beautifully.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to check that into the luggage now?
And I then think have, you carry it
and
on.
And then watch them do the luggage throw? No.
The shot put.
So then you're now, instead of your personal bag, you're going to prioritize your small four factor in.
Get
a lot
to the performance. But it doesn't
to me,
actually perform.
Here's the question. Okay. That's why I got Steve here, because he is the performance person. Is a small form factor, another argument I have is a small form factor is not going to perform as well as a desktop. In general, because it's simple physics. I got a bigger power supply. I got bigger cooling. I can't jam all that into a small form factor box. No matter what. There's an upper limit.
If you take like a geometric average of the performance of all small form factor versus all of your super towers, probably you are correct.
See?
So that's the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Gordon's right. That's the new subtitle for the video.
Right.
Small form factor sucks, : Gordon is right.
In your coupe. And if you don't like it, I know you drive a coupe, so.
Realistically, if you build with an actually ventilated mini ITX case or something. I mean, especially if you're not doing like a 3090 Ti, the performance shouldn't be that different. I hate to say it because I don't want to torpedo your argument.
Because I want to know the truth as much as I want to be a reasonable person. And if Steve says,
you lose about I forget what the smallest division is these days for GPU clocks per gradient temperature, but you lose something like 5 to 12 megahertz for maybe every 5 degrees Celsius on an RTX 30 series card, and it scales all the way down to negative 80 degrees and all the way up to 96 degrees. So for every couple degrees, you're increasing the temperature of the ambient in the case. So that's the air that the GPU breathes, right? Every couple degrees, you're gonna lose some amount of frequency, maybe 12 megahertz. Does that affect the FPS? Not really, but you are technically, purely on a technicality, losing performance. If you build in a crammed box that has poor airflow, or you build something, I'm gonna throw you a bone, Gordon, all right? Here's what I'm gonna do. You build in something like the Fantex Evolve X or whatever it was, the original small form factor tower, and it orients it such that your pump is effectively at the top of the loop, and you basically have to use like a 120 mil or something CLC. And so, liquid cooler. So there's definitely really bad ITX designs. I would say there's probably a much greater overall loss if you build in a bad ITX case than a bad ATX case. But yeah, you know, just in terms of, they're working with small space, so they do a lot of weird things.
Right.
Right. So yeah, the build experience is normally not great. But I really like the NR200, the Cooler Master one, because you could pull every panel off, so it's not as much of a pain in the butt to build. Right. And it shouldn't lose too much performance because it's pretty ventilated.
Okay. So you're basically saying you can approach the performance, so it's,
I think it
mostly
takes,
negligible.
It takes more care, yeah. I think in an ATX case, especially if it's got a mesh front, you don't really need to think too hard about the other components. But ITX, you have to put all this effort into, like, what cooler do you use? And the CPU is going to be really, your choice is limited if you can only put a 120 mil liquid cooler in it or something.
Right.
So performance is a factor, but I think it can be managed.
Okay. But full size case, you just build into it, you don't think about it as much. You don't
have
to.
For the most part, yeah.
But you just have to get into a small form factor build, think about it, optimize it.
Right.
I know that's cool if you want to do it, but I don't want to waste my time. My time is, and that's why I don't want to do it, because I don't want to think about it.
Well, you're a big shot at PC World.
No,
so.
I'm just too, I want to build it, never think about it for 10 years. And to me, that's important. So for me, it doesn't work. That's why it sucks. But so it sounds like, I'm right. So there can be a performance hit. And I'm not even mentioning my trump card is.
This is like a mainstream, like, news right up now. They're like, wait a minute, did you say there can't sometimes? Sometimes. There's a performance hit for small form factor PCs. We got them.
That would be it. That we got it. Here's my trump card, Threadripper. You cannot do a Threadripper build in small form factor. I mean, I want to see the mini ITX Threadripper board.
ASRock has one, I think.
Is it? Damn.
There is one.
For Pro?
I don't know about Pro, but I think for 3,000 they did. I'm not 100%. I think they did.
I mean, it's just simple physics.
To be fair to you, though, I don't know what you do for a cooler on that. Like, I'm sure someone in the audience has done it, but you don't have a lot of space to cool, you know, 200 plus watts on a CPU.
Right.
So.
Or you're not going to run a, right, you know, 1.5 kilo. You know.
But you just don't think there's any situation at any point where you even could use a small form factor PC instead of a full tower.
No, I mean, when I'm saying I think they suck,
Gordon's here in his ivory tower.
I'm in my
huge
you
house.
Should just have a big computer. I have had many small form factor builds in the past, and I just realized it's just not worth it to me at this point. It's just like, I'd rather just have the tower experience, and I don't understand the amount of, I don't, for me again, who doesn't have that much time on this planet, I don't want to spend all this time thinking about what parts I'm building and how I'm going to optimize it, and where I could just and not think about it.
So when you're in your last days, you don't want to be thinking, man, I wish I didn't spend 3 hours rebuilding computer.
That's 3 hours. You're like, I could have been frolicking in a grass field instead of like, oh, damn, I can't fit this fan in here.
Yeah, right. That's right? A valid argument. Yeah.
That is, and that's
right.
That's,
and
not
that's why
up.
Small form factor sucks.
That's why small form factor sucks.
Yeah, problem solved.
So anyway, PC World fans, yes, this is my personal opinion. If you have a small form factor or you drive a coupe, That's fine. That's right. Fine. For me, I'm not driving a coupe. I'm not sitting in back in your coupe, and I'm not going to build a small four-vector build.
Right, because...
And Steve agrees.
Because when you're dying, you'll regret having spent the time installing a cooler in it. Is
yes,
that the conclusion
yes,
came
and the
to?
Reason, yes.
I think that's the conclusion
I will
came
be.
To.
I will regretting the time I've spent building, trying to put a cooler into a small four-vector
right.
build. Anyway, come back to PC World's channel for more video coverage of PC topics like crazy-ass stuff that Gordon says like this. And, of course, go to Gamers Nexus channel and subscribe over there as well. Thanks for coming, Steve.
Thank you.